प्लांट किंगडम पार्ट 3 इन वॉइस ऑफ सुयेशी विनीत 3.4 जिम्नोस्पर्म्स द जिम्नोस्पर्म्स जिम्नोस मीनिंग नेकेड एंड स्पर्मा मीनिंग सीड्स आर प्लांट्स इन विच द ओव्यूल्स आर नॉट एनक्लोज्ड बाय एनी ओवरी वॉल एंड रिमेन एक्सपोज्ड बोथ बिफोर एंड आफ्टर फर्टिलाइजेशन द सीड दैट डेवलप पोस्ट फर्टिलाइजेशन आर नॉट कवर्ड दैट इज आर नेकेड जिम्नोस्पर्म इंक्लूड मीडियम साइज ट्रीज और टॉल ट्रीज एंड शर्ब्स वन ऑफ द जिम्नोस्पर्म्स द जायंट रेडवुड ट्री सेक्योया इज वन ऑफ द टॉलेस्ट ट्रीज species. The roots are generally taproot. Roots in some genera have fungal association in the form of mycorrhiza pinus. While in some others, as in cycas, small specialized roots called coralloid roots are associated with N2-fixing cyanobacteria. The stems are unbranched in cycas or branched in pinus and cedrus. I repeat, the stems are unbranched in cycas, branched in pinus and cedrus. The leaves may be simple or compound. In cycas, the pinnate leaves persist for a few years. The leaves in gymnosperms are well adapted to withstand extremes of temperature, humidity and wind. In conifers, the needle-like leaves reduce the surface area. Their thick cuticle and sunken stomata also help to reduce water loss. The gymnosperms are heterosporous. They produce haploid microspores and megaspores. The two kinds of spores are produced within sporangia that are borne on sporophylls which are arranged spirally along an axis to form lax or compact strobili or cones. The strobili bearing microsporophylls and microsporangia are called microsporangiate or male strobili. The microspores develop into a male gametophytic generation which is highly reduced and confined to only a limited number of cells. The reduced gametophyte is called a pollen grain. The development of pollen grain takes place within the microsporangia. The cones bearing megasporophylls with ovules or megasporangia are called macrosporangiate or female strobili. The male or female strobili The male or female cones or strobili may be born on the same tree as in pinus or on different tree as in cycas. The megaspore mother cell is differentiated from one of the cells of the nucellus. The nucellus is protected by envelope and the composite structure is called an ovule. The ovules are born on megasporophylls which may be clustered to form female cones. The megaspore mother cell divides meiotically to form 4 megaspores. One of the megaspores encloses within megasporangium nucellus, develops into a multicellular female gametophyte that bears 2 or more archegonia or female sex organ. The multicellular female gametophyte is also retained within megasporangium. Unlike bryophytes and pteridophytes, in gymnosperm, the male and female gametes do not have an independent free living existence. They remain within the sporangia retained on the sporophyte. The pollen grain is released from microsporangium. They are carried in air currents and come in contact with the opening of ovule born on megasporophyll. The pollen tube carrying the male gametes grow towards archegonia in the ovules and discharge their contents near the mouth of the archegonia. Following fertilization, zygote develops into an embryo and the ovule into seeds. These seeds are not covered. I repeat, these seeds are not covered. 3.5 Angiosperms. Unlike the gymnosperms, where the ovules are naked, in the angiosperms or flowering plants, the pollen grain and ovules are developed in specialized structures called flower. In angiosperm, the seeds are enclosed by fruits. The angiosperms are exceptionally large group of plants occurring in wide range of habitats. They range in size from tiny, almost microscopic wolfia to tall trees of eucalyptus, which is over 100 meters. They provide us with food, fodder, fuel, medicine, and several other commercially important products. They are divided into two classes, the dicotyledons and the monocotyledons. The dicotyledons are characterized by
having two cotyledons in their seeds, while the monocotyledonous have only one. I repeat, the dicotyledons are characterized by having two cotyledons in their seeds, while the monocotyledons have one. The male sex organ in a flower is the stamen. Each stamen consists of a slender filament with an anther at the tip. The anthers following meiosis produce pollen grains. The female sex organ in a flower is the pistil or the carpel. Pistil consists of an ovary enclosing one to many ovules. Within ovules are present highly reduced female gametophytes termed embryo sacs. The embryo sac formation is preceded by meiosis. Hence, each of the cells of an embryo sac is haploid. Each embryo sac has three-celled egg apparatus, one egg cell and two synergids, three antipodal cells and two polar cells. The polar nuclei eventually fuse to produce a diploid secondary nucellus. The polar nuclei eventually fuse to produce a diploid secondary nucleus. Pollen grains after dispersal from the anthers are carried by wind or various other agencies to the stigma of a pistil. This is termed as pollination. The pollen grain germinate on the stigma and the resulting pollen tubes grow through the tissue of stigma and style and reach the ovule. The pollen tubes enter the embryo sac where two male gametes are discharged. One of the male gametes fuses with the egg cell to form a zygote, syngamy. The other male gamete fuses with the diploid secondary nucleus to produce the triploid primary endosperm nucleus, PEN, primary endosperm nucleus. Because of the involvement of two fusions, this event is termed as double fertilization, an event unique to angiosperms. The zygote develops into an embryo with one or two cotyledons and the pen develops into endosperm, which provides nourishment to the developing embryo. The synergids and antipodals degenerate after fertilization. During these events, the ovules develop into seeds and the ovaries develop into fruits. The life cycle of an angiosperm is shown in this figure. Look at the figure, the life cycle of an angiosperm. 3.6 Plant life cycle and alternation of generation. In plants, both haploid and diploid cells can divide by mitosis. This ability leads to the formation of different plant bodies, haploid and diploid. The haploid plant body produces gametes by mitosis. The haploid plant body produces gametes by mitosis. This plant body represents a gametophyte. Following fertilization, the zygote also divides by mitosis to produce a diploid sporophytic plant body. Haploid spores are produced by this plant body by meiosis. These in turn divide by mitosis to form haploid plant body once again. Thus, during the life cycle of any sexually reproducing plant, there is alternation of generation between gamete-producing haploid gametophyte and spore-producing diploid sporophyte. However, different plant groups as well as individuals representing them differ in the following patterns. Sporophytic generation is represented only by one cell, zygote. There are no free-living sporophytes. Meiosis in the zygote result in the formation of haploid spores. The haploid spores divide mitotically and form the gametophyte. The dominant photosynthetic phase in such plants is the free-living gametophyte. This kind of life cycle is termed as haplontic. Many algae such as Volvox, Spirogyra and some species of Chlamydomonas represent this haplontic pattern. Second, on the other extreme, this is the type wherein the diploid sporophyte is the dominant photosynthetic independent phase of the plant. The gametophyte phase is represented by single to few celled haploid gametophyte. This kind of life cycle is termed as diplontic, where the gametophytic phase is represented by single to few celled haploid gametophytes. All seed-bearing plants, that is gymnosperms and angiosperms, follow this pattern. Number 3. Bryophytes and pteridophytes interestingly exhibit an intermediate condition, haplodiplontic phase, where both phases are multicellular and often free-living. However, they differ in their dominant phase. A dominant independent photosynthetic thalloid or erect phase is represented by a haploid gametophyte, and it alternates with the short-lived multicellular sporophyte, totally or partially dependent on the gametophyte for its anchorage and nutrition. All bryophytes represent this pattern. The diploid sporophyte is represented by a dominant independent photosynthetic vascular plant body. It alternates with multicellular saprophytic/autotrophic independent but short-lived haploid gametophyte. Such a pattern is known as haplodiplontic life cycle. All pteridophytes exhibit this pattern. Interestingly, while most algal genera are haplontic, some of them, such as Ectocarpus, Polysiphonia, Kelps, are haplodiplontic. Fucus is an alga which is diplontic. Thank you. Please like, share, and subscribe to Neetshala.